Good morning. This is Bobby Dupre with the Bobby Dupre Show, presented to you each Thursday morning at 7 a.m. And, of course, the television on the cable companies, it replays at 3 p.m. on Sunday afternoon. Those of you watching it on the Internet by way of your iPad, your computer, your iPhone, whatever, I'll get it out in a minute. Internet device you use. You can be watching it, of course, 24 hours a day after the first program runs immediately after 8 o'clock on Thursday morning. You can start watching it 24 hours a day. And I want to make an introduction right now over here with my sidekick today is no newcomer to me or to the KDCG television fans. Some years ago, you had a well-liked and a very talked-about talk show. Tell us just briefly what was that about. Reggie Tatum. I'm sorry. I'm taking it. I know him well, but right. You might not know him. And wondering why is... Well, Matt's on vacation, and he deserves to be on the vacation, believe me.
Right.
He puts in a lot of hours around this station. Whenever he's needed, he's around. Reggie, of course, is the mayor of Opelousas, serving your first term as mayor. We'll let you tell you a little bit about your time that you had the talk show, medical talk show.
Right. The show was Healthwise, to those of you that remember, and it was basically a talk show where we talked about current issues and what we thought affected the community, and we had different doctors, and we also had nurses, and different people from in the medical field, and we used to talk about all the different concerns. We talk about the flu during the flu season. We talk about snake bites during hunting season. Whatever it we thought pertained to what everybody wanted to hear.
And Reggie hosted this show for 2 to 3 years, probably closer to 3 years, and I personally enjoyed it a lot of times. But as times change, things change. I guess the station couldn't get enough sponsors at the time.
Right.
It all goes, it's all about dollars. And of course, I was telling Reggie just before going on the air that my plan is at the end of the year, the first part of next year, I'll be exiting off the Bobby Dupre Show myself. 40 years, I've been dedicated to the program. I love it. The people have been overwhelmed. They've overwhelmed me with warmth and good words, and we enjoy your program, and I mean, everything good. But then it's 40 years, and I have to be here every Wednesday. And I've got to make sure that I've got enough material to cover.
Right.
You don't just get up here and talk. You've got to have material to keep it interesting, a lot of different subjects. And that tells me we need to move right on into that. We decided we'd start with the obituaries. Is that right? We have a little bit different setup here today. Dylan is working right in front of me instead of in the back on the other side. Andre, who's a student at UL, is monitoring some device on the other side. And Matt LeBlanc, who's on vacation, kind of left us in a bind here. We're having to kind of patch up things. And then Dylan will put his knowledge that he's learned in a couple of years he's been here as an intern. And, of course, now he's a full-fledged employee of Delta Media. And I congratulate you on that. You didn't have to go far to get your work. You knew where you were coming before you got the job. So anyhow, we're going to start off with, we'll try to do it as good as we can. And I'm sure when Matt comes in next week, he'll be able to figure it up. But we're going to start with obituary. And where are my obituaries? They're right here. First one is a longtime person who also had a TV program on KDCG.
That's right.
And I'm speaking of Mr. Daniel White. It was Daniel White and Sean Dejean. They had a very interesting...
Salt and pepper.
Salt and pepper. That's what they called themselves. And Mr. Daniel was... I remember him working at Buster's Dinner Club, where the St. Landry Bank North End branch bank is, uh-huh, on the North End, North Main Street, right in that area there where that hotel is. Buster's Dinner Club. That's before your time,
oh, that was,
I think.
Yeah, that was a good little bit before my time.
When that place closed down, he moved over to Swallows and worked at Swallows as a waiter for a long time. In the meantime, he got involved with selling burial insurance and did very well. And he saved his coins and ended up having his own property and casualty insurance agency, Daniel White Insurance Agency. And also had quite a few rental units right next to our office, where the OPAC office is, right across the street. He's got a two-story apartment complex there.
Right.
And a couple of others.
On Madison Street and on Jefferson. I mean, he's
so anyhow,
a lot of property.
A young man that didn't get a fast start, but he ended up strong and just such a likable guy. Such a likable guy. But we all got it going. My sympathies to his family. And I heard some good news about him, and we won't get into that matter, but that sounded good to me. Next one, it'll be Shelton Daigle. Shelton was a customer of mine. He had a construction company and in the oil field. He was a welder and had a very successful business career. Got into promoting of products, invention of products. He could think things through very, very carefully. And I know Andrew's the young daughter, Austin, and little Andrew were babysat by Shelton's wife, if I'm not mistaken.
Okay.
I think I overheard Andrew mentioning.
Was he kin to the Daigles that have the Daigle welding?
I really don't know his. He was on the north end of town on the old Washington Highway there.
Right.
He was just off on Compress. He lived right in that area there.
Okay.
But I'm not sure who his background was. And there's a lady here, Marguerite Lucille Mamalakis Gorab, and it shows that she was born in November of 1927 in Opelousas. She was the daughter of George Emmanuel Mamalakis and Frances Guidry Mamalakis. And I'm pretty sure that that's the same Mamalakis, Bill Mamalakis, who worked with us, big, tall, slim. He started out working with us. He got a good offer to go to work for Valero in Crouch Springs. They saw his brightness, his sharpness, his smartness, and they brought him into the home office in San Antonio, and he's there doing very, very well. So his daddy, I can't think of his daddy's first name, but everybody knew him in town. He worked at the post office for years. And then he closed out his career. He was a greeter when Walmarts had greeters. For years, they had greeters. I wish they still had that. That was made you feel good, them checking the products. And I bet you saving that little $7
right.
or $8 an hour, there's a lot more goods walking out of that store than that little cost. Mr.
Right.
Sam's turning over in his grave.
Mm-hmm.
Next young person was Miss Jane Lambert. I knew Jane. She was a Jane Huguet. And of course, that's the Huguet family, Miss
Norma,
Mr. Wilbur Huguet. That would be, I don't know if it's his sister. It sure is. Norma and Larry Wayne Huguet. Of course, that goes to one sister, Barbara Latchley, and her husband, Larry Latchley, service builders, that era. And that time, the era, not an E-E, it's an E-R-A, not an E-R-R-O-R. Larry, don't get mad at me. A special friend, very close friend, Dr. Gary Blanchard, who took care of her so, so well. Miss Jane Lambert passed away. And Edward J. Butte, didn't know for sure, but he was called Eddie. And Eddie Butte, my age, or maybe even a little older, he would probably, if he was alive, he'd probably be about 80. He was our best truck driver we had, trailer driver we had at Mud Supply Company when I was working my way through college. Just, if anybody knows if that's the Eddie Butte, I wish y'all would personally give me a call, 945. 4010, Bobby Dupre.
And he would always be around with Roscoe Chenier. We had talked about that, how he would be at Roscoe's house a lot of times when I would go over there.
Right.
So
Paul Roscoe. David, I think it's Edmund is last
right,
name.
David Edmund.
Yeah, he's going to play for our fundraiser we're going to have for Ludrika. By right. the way, I can bring that up right now. Ludrika Theory, she listens, she acts, she gets the job done. She's presently a state representative running for state senator. On October, I think the election is in October, but on Wednesday, next Wednesday, August the 5th, from 6 to 8 p.m. at the Equine Sales Center, we're having a fundraiser. Donation is $100 per person. If you need a ticket or you need a free ticket, contact me, and I've bought a number of them, and so I can assist you.
Right.
And if you want to make a check, make it out to the Ludrika Theory campaign. And she's running for Senate District number 24, which is being vacated
by Elbert
Lee Gillery, who's now running for Lieutenant Governor of the state of Louisiana. And so I am openly backing Ludrika Theory, intelligent young lady from the Palmetto, LeBoer area, graduated from North Central High school, went on to college, became an attorney. I think she was a school teacher.
She was a school teacher first, and then she
went to very bright, very, very fun working within this campaign. She tends to her business. She answers her phone calls.
And also, she has Theories Insurance.
On the Washington Highway. You certainly correct that. So anyhow, the next person that we're going to talk about that passed away recently is Jack Johnson. Jack lived, I guess, his whole life because his mom and daddy were from Leonville. And it says here that he was one of the attendees at the squirrel hunt extravaganza that Jimmy Prados organized so well for so many years. He was one of our musicians and a fun guy to be around. And his daddy and my daddy worked together at the Higgins Shipyard during the Second World War. So. Boy, I can remember little things like that, and I can't remember who I met yesterday. That's starting to tell that 78 years is coming upon me. This is a memoriam here. This is not a recent death. He actually died in 1993, but Mr. Weston Singleton. When I see these, it just brings back fond memories of how I met him. I met him through his brother-in-law, Lewis Carrier. Lewis Carrier was a believer in Bobby Dupre. Whatever I did, whether it was selling them insurance for their buses that brought these employees to all these jobs and the Baton Rouge jobs, and then the Lake Charles, I insured all those buses that made that run and went and got them an increase. I had Tracy Bostel represent them and got a 50 cents a week increase.
Per day.
Fond memories.
Oh, yeah.
And Mr. Singleton, I met his son. There's a picture, I'm going to show a picture of Miss Laura in there a little bit later. And that's the reason I had just cut this out that morning, and I met his grandson who works with Lee Lang at his horse barn right by Christ the King Church on the southwest end of town of Opelousas, still in St. Landry Parish. And he says, "You remember me?" I said, "Yeah, it was a Sunday I met you. I was with Carl DeVille. We were looking at some horses at your ranch, what you work at. It was a Sunday, it was rainy, and it was cold. He said, "Mr. Bobby, how you keep up with all that?" Well, I said, the Singleton family, several of them got my scholarships at from OHS, So I don't know, good people.
Good memories.
Good memories. The next one would be Richard Michael Lopez. I think he went by name of Mike. I didn't really know him that well, but I knew his brother. I know his brother, Al Edward. I know Ed. I know Al and Norma and Donna, and his special friend that he was close to was Robin. And he was born in Opelousas, and he was, of course, he was preceded in death by his father, Julius Lambert, who for years worked with the federal bankruptcy court in Lafayette. I remember that very well. And his mama was a well-known person, Miss Rosa May Lopez. So my deepest sympathies. He was known around Opelousas for selling these big pots. And we're going to get the next obituaries is going to be dealing with the shooting that took place at the theater, and we'll come right back with 1 minute break. Welcome back to the second quarter of the Bobby Dupre Show, along with my sidekick today, Mr. Reggie Tatum, mayor of Opelousas, Louisiana. Boy, you never dreamed, I bet, you'd ever be the mayor of Opelousas.
Nope. I was content being my little paramedic and just doing that kind of thing, helping the people.
Yeah,
I never thought I'd
But that's what you're doing as mayor.
Right.
I remember 6 weeks ago, I needed something done for a good citizen in Opelousas.
Right.
The McCormick family needed some attention, and I went to the top. I didn't know who to go lower than that, but you met with Joey Doucette,
right,
one of our good sponsors on the show. We'll mention Joey Doucette and the McCormick companies. They have some great storage buildings, and that's what they're doing with the former
Dixie Glass
manufacturing division,
right,
on Landry Street. Large buildings on properties on both sides of the street there,
right,
and that's where I started my consumer loan business right there. Mr. McCormick got me started at $100 a month rent. I'd pay him about November,
wow,
the month, the year. I'd pay him a year ahead of time, and he'd laugh. He'd tell everybody, "That Bobby's slick, yeah." He's paying me. We were doing that as a joke, you know. But he long as I stayed there and he was alive,
right,
it cost me $100 a month. What a man!
But,
and what a facility they have in Port Barry and storages in Opelousas, and then now they're gonna take that and transform it into another good, successful business.
I think it's 100,000 square feet.
Oh, I'm
like
sure
that.
It
easy,
is. Oh,
easy.
Yeah.
Over 100,000 square feet.
Okay, we need to get back on track. I went a little bit. I didn't get my sponsors going, so I want to touch up on my sponsors. One that is on twice a month. I have to say it, J.B. Sandals. They have been in business for over 135 years and still going strong. Neil, keep it up, young man. We love you. And if you need anything that you think you can buy at a hardware store or a store where you want to maybe buy a gift for a loved one, get married or something, they'll wrap it up for you. They take care of the whole thing. J.B. Sandals. And, of course, the Medicine Shop Pharmacy. Dirk Andrepont and his wife Liz have a store that they're very proud of on, that would be on South Union Street. And you having problems maybe remembering your pharmacy dates, the renewals of your meds and all, they have a program, Simplify My Meds, and it makes it simple. And if you're taking care of others, you're helping out with your parents or a neighbor next door or aunt or an uncle,
makes it easy
not unusual that you kind of get involved in helping them with the meds. The Medicine Shop Pharmacy can certainly help you with that, and they deliver in the Opelousas area, and they can ship just about
anywhere.
And so when the next time you're needing a new, maybe you want to change pharmacy or something like that, look up the Medicine Shop Pharmacy. Dirk Andrepont and his wife Liz would be glad to talk to you and start you a brand new account. And the next sponsor we'll talk about is Piggly Wiggly. Kevin Doucette and Joey Quibido do a great job. They have on the north end is where their first store was, and it's still doing a bang up job.
Right
next to where Service Builders was. It's on the right when you're heading north towards Washington.
Across from Slim's Waikiki.
That's correct. That's a good place to know, good place to be located across, because you can just tell them where you're located and they'll find it, because people have been going to Slim's for years and years. They have it on the north end, and then on the south end, they've recently, about 3 weeks ago, changed over to a different method of pricing and selling, and it's known as the Cash Saver Store now. That's the location on the south end. Same owners, Joy will be there to help you. The butcher will be there to help you. All your clerks. In fact, they've added a couple of more clerks to make sure that when you get to the cash register,
that
somebody's going to be there to get you out of the store and onto your home or wherever you plan on going. So Cash Saver and Piggly Wiggly has also, Kevin has a store in Simsport. It's a good community store there. They do a bang-up job. Good luck to you guys. And the Steamboat Warehouse, better known
good
as
food.
The historic, located in historic Washington on historic Bayou Catawba. And the building was built in 1825. That's a long time. That's before my first birthday.
Yeah.
Quite a while before my first birthday. But we certainly can go there. You've got good, fresh seafoods at all times. The steaks are the highest quality you can buy.
Excellent.
Jason Huguet just has a knack of getting the food out to you promptly and in a delicious manner. And a manner that you're ready to cut into that steak the way they do it up. And of course, if you want to drink a little drink or something, you can walk out on the patio on the backside and watch the birds and watch the water run in beautiful historic
I remember when Jason was, it wasn't his, he was just working there for Peanut
and Frankie Elder, that's right. And now he's the owner of the land and the business. So what a young man, great, keep up the good work. And we have to catch up a couple because we didn't do any of the first portion. So we'll go to the Quarters Casino. And don't forget the El Pico de Diego and the Chevron Fuel. They have the front portion of the location is for the automobile, but they do have diesel fuel for the pick-up trucks and the cars that use diesel. But well lit and then a huge parking in the back with good air tanks just been added on, some nice air tanks for the big trucks that want to check their tires, make sure everything is rolling along
full service.
And of course they've got video poker machines, they've got a Subway, they've got a full
and it's a Stuckey's, I think, in there too. I think
Stuckey's, they have Stuckey's products in there. They have Hunt Brothers pizza, and of course the El Pico de Diego Mexican food is authentic.
Right.
He is a full-fledged Mexican and proud of it. Probably an American Mexican,
but
Mexican heredity. Okay, good. The next one will be Kip Bertrand, the president and CEO of St. Landry Homestead. Hopes that next time you're looking to open a new account, you'll consider their locations in Eunice, which is a new location on the east end of the city. They used to be, I guess you'd say, kind of downtown in the middle of the town, but they've moved to the east end and a nice facility there, rather new facility. And of course, they're in Port Barrett. They've already purchased the land. I guess they're just building up some more money, so that when they build the new Port Barrett location, it's going to be a first-class one. Although everything inside the building they're presently in has been updated and all online. If you want to do online banking, consider St. Landry Homestead. And of course, the main branch is downtown. And I think that Homestead, I'm not looking at it here, but I think they started the Homestead Association back then in 19, maybe 24, something like that. It reminds me of those days. It's been around, it stood the test of time. And they are really on top of the game. And so we okay on our sponsors.
Okay.
And I'll put this right here. And then we're gonna go back. And we had a lot of obituaries. It's unusual amount, and I hope I'm not boring. I hope you are interested in the way I try to handle these the best I can. There was a tragic shooting that took place at the Grand Theater in Lafayette, Louisiana, our neighbor. Our neighbor where we are right now,
right.
And a neighbor where you and I from Opelousas, live in Opelousas, it's still a neighbor.
Right.
And really shook up the community. We had read and we had heard so much about the young man that had walked into a theater in, Colorado, I think it was, and killed 12 people and wounded another maybe 75. And his trial has just taken place, and they're now in the sentencing portion, and under consideration is the death penalty. And his father went and spoke on his behalf, asking to plead for his life. So I don't know, that's not what I get into, but I'm just showing you how these things continue to happen, and they don't think it's happening
just
in Chicago or Detroit or New York City or Colorado. This is home right here. And but we can't be afraid. We have to be strong, Lafayette. Is that the new?
Lafayette Strong, right.
Lafayette Strong. They are really doing a great job of getting signage out, T-shirts out, and showing the community and showing the people that do bad things that this is not the place
that's
to come
gonna,
and do
not,
it. You're not going to break us down.
Right.
You're not going to keep us home. I hope that when the theater reopens, it's been turned over to them, the owners, the investigation portion is complete. Monday afternoon, I think it was, the theater was turned over. Now they're going to have to remodel it, and it really messed up one
right.
section.
Right.
And I hope that the people have the confidence to go back and take care of
business. I think they will.
I hope so. It's a question mark. There's been some places that had to close after things like this happened. I hope that that doesn't happen in Lafayette here.
Well, they were talking about maybe making that one particular theater, that part of the theater as a memorial. So they were talking about
never
maybe
thought
that.
About that.
Right.
That, you know, that there's always some smart people out there thinking that would be a good idea. We're going to talk about one of the young ladies. The first one will be Macy Marie Bro. She was born in September 25th, 1993, and this occurrence took place July the 23rd, last Thursday of 2015. I think she's, 21 years old, and just a beautiful young lady, the time of her life. She was in school. I don't think she had graduated yet. Am I correct, Dylan?
No, not yet.
Doesn't think she had graduated yet. She was from Franklin, Louisiana. She was buried. I think the burial took place Monday. Huge, huge turnouts. Can you imagine having to go there and you know, but the support that the communities are giving is unbelievable.
Unbelievable support.
Unbelievable. And the other person that was killed, and then there were, I think, a total of, nine that were injured. Were shot. And most of them out of the hospital. Maybe two might still be in. But the other young lady that got killed was from, lived in the Lafayette area and had a business in River Ranch. And apparently, a beautiful person in and out. Just very active in the community. She touched a lot of lives. It kind of reminds me of the little Shunick girl that got run over on that bicycle.
Right.
Well, not run over, kidnapped and then
the
murdered.
Bicycle, right.
Yeah, riding a bicycle. That the community turned out for her family and her support and her friends and family. Mm-hmm. And the same thing is taking place for Jillian Johnson. She was in her early 30s. She just had a following of in the artistic. She had a band. I mean, she was just
everything.
You know, just everything.
Mm-hmm.
Our sympathies, I know I'm speaking for you,
sure.
as well as all of us with the Delta Media here in Karen Crow, speak for all of us. Anything that I can certainly do and promote and bring to notice of an event taking place, please don't hesitate. Get me that information and we'll get it on the program. We tape on
sure.
Wednesday mornings. That's what we're taping right now. And I want to thank you again. I don't think
sure.
I formally thanked you. I thanked you before.
No problem. No problem. Glad to be here.
We have, we'll need a 1-minute break You want to do the Bobby Christina Brown death, Whitney Houston's daughter. She had been in a coma for 6 or 8 months.
Now.
Finally, God took her where she can be with her mama, who died.
The same way, tragic.
Yes, tragic death to the mama. And we'll get, you want me to get Mr. Chris too? Okay, that's Mr. Ted Lewis Chris. We called him Ted Chris, Ashley and Kermit's brother. Ashley, of course, is deceased prior to this. Mr. Ted gave me a little boat and trailer, and I have it. I thought about it. I thought I was going to have it for today's program. It was a Napa product, but I think it's at my little office back at the bank. I don't go there very often, and I went there yesterday, and I opened the door, and I turned the alarm system on, and messed up. I didn't want to go there this morning and run into problems and get all heated up,
right?
Hot. But hopefully I'll remember to bring that little, I cherish that
it's
little.
It's a little boat? It's a little.
Well, it's just a little miniature boat.
Oh, it's a model.
Yeah,
it's
yeah,
model.
It's a little model.
Okay.
Yeah. It was a Napa product that they sold around Christmas time, and he gave it to me as a Christmas gift. I don't think I wrote down what the year, but it's years ago. He said I had done a little favor for him, and he wanted to repay me. And that's how Uncle Ash, his brother Ashley, and of course his brother Kermit, of course, is married to Joanne, my first cousin. So we all kin one way or the other, our deepest sympathy. And also Mr. Colder here, Richard Colder Jr. When we started the Orphan Train Museum movement in Opelousas, there was a young lady from the Lawtell, Lewisburg area that was a member of this Colder family. I don't know if they happen to be watching the program or somebody knows who I'm talking about. I wish she would give me a call. She was very helpful in organizing the movement when we started it, and maybe she's still part of the movement and I'm not aware of it. So anyhow, that's the family. Somebody in that family came from New York City, like my dad and so many others did in Acadiana and Louisiana and the rest of the United States. Welcome back to the third quarter of the Bobby Dupre Show, presented to you each Thursday morning beginning at 7 a.m. and replays in its entirety on the cable and, the cable services throughout Acadiana, I might add. And that's at 3 p.m. on Sunday afternoon. But on the computer, the internet services, that whatever way you're using it, the computer or your iPad or your iPhones, those devices, that's 24 hours a day beginning at 8:01 a.m. on Thursday. So that can help you if you want to show someone a picture of yourself on there.
Sure.
Or maybe you heard me talking about one of the deaths and you liked what I said about the family or something personal, you might want to go to that section, look it up real quick.
Easy.
And on the Bobby Dupre Show, and it's easy to get KDCG and then get on
in the archives.
In the archives, that's correct. Okay, that first picture is a picture that we had shown, a tree that was there. We were cutting it down, and all you see now is some bare ground. And if it decides to rain again one day, we'll get some grass growing up.
There.
You'll never notice that there was ever a tree there, but apparently lightning had killed it during the past year. And this is a horseman who was an economic development guru for our St. Landry Parish in Acadiana area for a long time, came by way of St. Mary Parish. And of course, he was born and I guess raised in the Ville Platte area. And I'm speaking of Gerard Perron, the cowboy. He wears that big white hat now. He's the guy with the big, he's looking at a replay of his race that his horse had just won, by the way. He is not just the owner of the horse, he raised the horse from a baby. So he's the trainer of
the
horse.
He's the trainer too. Wow.
So he gets the whole kit and caboodle, just about the whole thing. And next to him on his going from left to right is his brother, Donnie Perron, who is now a school board member, retired from the St. Leonard Parish School System, a very successful career, I might add. And then that's their cousins, the Peets. And can't think of the first name, apologize that for that. Maybe her name is Ann, because she looked at me straight in the face and I think she said Ann. But anyhow, good, I've seen them before, I know who they are. Keep up the good work, Gerard. And this is the back of a shirt that I thought was pretty. See that craft, that's a shrimp. That's a shrimp at the Bolivar Yacht Basin Bait Camp. That's where Joe Ramey and myself and our partner from the fishing rodeo. LeBon. So anyhow, we had a great time, and we're going to go to the next picture now.
My question is, you didn't tell if you what you did in the rodeo. Did y'all win?
Well, I got a prize. I got a nice plaque. Mm-hmm. I had it didn't say the largest, but speckled trout. And I did fish Thursday, Friday, and Saturday, about 5 hours each trip.
5 hours.
Hot sun with that white skin. But I douched myself up real good with sunscreen, and I didn't burn. You know, no peeling or nothing. Wow. It works. So, and I was using the number 30. That's what Dr. Doucette suggested to me years ago.
30, up to 30. At least 30.
But over that is kind of just numbers.
Oh, right.
It looks like it. Good there. This picture here is Eddie. Over in Eunice, Louisiana, he has the motorcycle shop, the Goodyear store there. He's had some hard times the last couple of years. He's been undergoing some medical treatments for cancer. And he has a beautiful motorcycle shop. They look new, but they actually used motorcycles.
Where's that at?
It's in Eunice, Louisiana, right on the main highway, 190. On the right-hand side, and it's also the Goodyear Tire Shop. He owns that also. But the motorcycle shop is for sale. So if anybody, and he'll price it right, he needs to get out. It's just a little bit more than he can
handle
actually handle. And Ed is a fine, fine young man, and I hope that someone can take advantage. And they don't have to stay in the building. If they would rather bring it, like he said, maybe to I-49, somewhere between Opelousas and Lafayette on I-49. That would be a good location. Right. And he's got some beautiful bikes. Well, you can see them. They all look brand new. Lionel Malonso and I were looking at my little piece of land I have on Highway 358. And about noontime, we got hungry, so we went to see Miss Laura. Miss Laura fixed us up at Vidrine's Cafe in Lewisburg. What is it? The cafe with the largest steak in Acadiana.
32 ounces.
You can eat that, baby. Let me tell you, you are a man or a woman. They got some ladies can eat a lot too. Miss Laura suggested that we didn't know what we wanted, so she suggested a hamburger and some fries. And let me tell you, I can give it a big check mark by that. But Miss Laura, you're a sweetheart, baby. Love you. And over
George.
At one of the convenience stores was Earl George. Earl's been around. I'd like to know how many parties that man has worked. You have any idea?
I don't know, but he's been at every one I've been to. I've seen him working.
And fishing rodeo, he worked for years and years, helped us. And just a heck of a good guy. His brother died, two or three years ago now? Right. Time flies. Burvick George.
He
too was the same kind of guy. Good natured, always willing to do whatever it took to make the party roll.
Friend with everybody.
Yep, we love you. And this is a picture of 50 years ago when Rod Bernard and his wife got married. And of course, recently, during July, they got married in July the 25th, 1965. They celebrated 50 years of marriage, and they have two children, Shane and Shannon. And I remember Rod was raised across the street from my brother and sister-in-law, Cody and Wilda Dupre, on Crochet Street. And his daddy, Mr. Bernard, I think, worked for the post office. Something tells me he worked at the post office. But anyhow, Rod came out with a hot song back in 1958, "This Should Go On Forever." And it made it all the way to the Dick Clark
American show, Bandstand.
American Bandstand. That is saying a big, big statement. And of course, this is how they look. They still look beautiful and healthy, yeah, 50 years later. So, Rod, keep up the good work. I love y'all, and I love you, Rod. I've known you all of your life.
Rod still singing?
Yep, still. I think he does a little, but not much. And this is, well, I don't think I need to even make a introduction anymore. Lieutenant Clay Higgins with the St. Lander Parish Sheriff's Office. 2016.
He's running for president?
I don't know. They got the American flag in the back of it. But I'll tell you what he did a couple of maybe night or two ago. He was on the Jimmy Fallon show. Jimmy Fallon took over what, Dick, David Letterman
David
show?
Letterman. Uh-huh.
David Letterman show. And somebody sent the clip that Lieutenant Higgins did on the break-in at Stelly's grocery market and Stelly's gas station and all over there in LeBeau, a well-known place. And he really talked to the young man. They have a picture of the young man, but it's, you know, it's hard to distinguish. But somebody's going to recognize it, and somebody's going to help him.
Sure.
But they tell me Jimmy Fallon, I missed it. They said he was dying laughing. He just couldn't believe that this guy was so good. And he's got well into the millions of hits. They call it hits, I
yeah,
think.
Yeah, on the internet, right.
On the internet,
right.
Hits or uh-huh. I guess, whatever.
Call it hits.
I don't have Facebook. But I hear a lot of talk about it. It's very important. Keep up the good work. St. Lander Parish getting some good production. I'm going to have to come back and show this next week. This is the strongest man in the world, picking up over 6,000 pounds. But I'll come back when I can read everything and talk about it. This was a man from Alexandria, Louisiana.
And look, that boy is just bending.
Well,
from the weight.
You know what the weights were? That's some wheels off of a railroad car.
Wow. that's
what I'm told. That's what it was. It's some wheels.
Yeah.
And then this is the Laborde Law Firm, Laborde Earls Law Firm. They had a big bike giveaway, and this was recently done. That practice is in Lafayette. Laborde's hail from the Vaughan Parish area, mm-hmm. as well as the Earls, E-A-R-L-E-S, Earls family, Digger Earls. I think this is Digger Earls. And his dad is Mr. John Earls, and well known. And the Laborde's, of course, are extremely well known. In fact, they're the ones that started Tidewater Marine. And
right.
One of the Laborde's started three different companies that ended up on the American stock market, stock exchange. That's something.
A lot.
Anyhow, okay, then this was the last Sunday. Stopped in. We were going to Vaughan Parish, and we're going to visit Miss Marilyn Bordelon, that's Vicky's mama. And she says, I see some Indians dressed up, but why don't you walk back there with your camera, Bobby, and see what that's all about. Well, I met the nicest group. What are two, four, six? There were seven of one group. The gentleman second from the left is Mr. Edgar, better known as Gray Wolf Bush. Bush is their last name. And he called me up and gave me a little background of this group. They were supposed to be there on Saturday, but somehow or another, they got the wrong date. And they missed the event, the powwow that took place the Saturday. This is at the Vieux Village. That's the open arena there.
The farmer's market.
Farmer's market. And I'm really glad that Vicky said go talk to them, because they're some nice, good, strong people. Mr. Gray Wolf worked with the Federal Aviation Commission, retired there. And they listed as another group with the government agency that lists all these groups.
Okay.
And they're the Kanaisi Adi Band of the Lipan Apache. We all know the Apache Indians.
Right.
Well, they were a band that was attached to the Apaches. And I have the phone number for Mr. Gray Wolf, and I'm gonna get in touch with him, and we're gonna have lunch. Because there's a lot of connection. We have a lot of Indian heritage right in St. Landry Parish. Gene Labbe,
right,
who died 8808, I'll just mention in that because it's coming up real soon, an anniversary. His grandmother she looked just like an Indian off the Indian plains that we see on the
right.
movies and pictures we see in museums and all we go to. I have a picture of it. I told Miss Bertha, Jean's mama, when I saw it, I said, we should have an Indian casino in St. Landry
sure,
Parish.
Sure, we should. We have a lot of, well, you know, little
we kids. We got to cut off. We're going to come back. We got to take a minute break.
Right.
Welcome back to the fourth quarter of the Bobby Dupre Show, and it's going to be a little bit short. It's going to be abbreviated just a little bit. We kind of long-winded. My friend here that came on aboard, I knew we wouldn't have any problems going an hour. We could go several
could go
hours.
3 hours.
But Reggie Tatum, our present mayor of Opelousas and former host of a talk show himself, so he knows how the program works. It can be a lot of fun, and it's been a lot of fun.
Right.
And in fact, if we had run out of material, I was going to talk about you. The reason I have him, really one of the reasons I have him here is he was in jail last week. It was either bail or jail. And they had put the handcuffs on you, but somebody came through with the bail, so you out. I wanted you on the program to show you that, you know, some of your adversaries might be saying, well, he's still in jail, Mr. Dupre, you know, kind of picking at me. I said, no, he's right here with me. And I thank you again before I forget, because we're going to be running.
Sure.
We got a lot to go. We're going to get a couple of our good sponsors real quick. And we have, three more, the LHC group, which was started right there in St. Landry Parish in the little community, town of Palmetto, Louisiana. They're drinking coffee like I'm drinking right now, and I'm gonna take it. Dylan wanted me to drink some water. He said I was losing my voice, and I said, well, I'll just stick with my coffee. And they were drinking coffee and came up with the idea. And Ginger Myers and Keith Myers were the prominent people but there were other investors right there at the table. They all got in on it. And Ginger was a RN, and they needed an RN to make it work. It's how I remember the story. I hope
sure.
I'm giving it to you right.
That's right.
Now they're in approximately 30 states offering services, home health services and other medical. But in Opelousas, we're fortunate they have the health club, which is well maintained, as well as a big office building for the LHC medical side of it.
And right. home health also, they just built a new, you know, the
that's
new
correct.
Facility.
So
next
LHC
year.
Group does good work. Dixie Storage, we covered them already. We need Targill. And Targill is butcher supplies, and of course they package for hundreds of different firms and individual business owners who want to use that as a opening card, can kind of to use in sales.
Right.
They package seasoning, and they do it for people all over the world.
Worldwide.
Ted Bellard has really brought this company I don't know how far it's going to go, to be quite honest with you. He's got the whole block now, and across what used to be the railroad, where the
right.
railroad track,
right.
he's got that starting on that side too. So he just had an idea that when he bought Targill, all it had was the butcher supplies. If they had any seasoning, it was very minimum. But he has gone real strong, but never forgot the roots, because a lot of the seasoning and all is done for restaurants and all. So who needs good butcher supplies but those type of commercial facilities. So good idea, good business. And then we have Carl's Thrifty Way. Carl's, of course, is not only known for his compounding that he is licensed to do, compounding of the, so it's easier for people to maybe remember and easier for them to take, absorb into the body. So, and then they have a complete pharmacy products of all the different medicines that you'll be prescribed when you visit your doctor. And then they have a beautiful gifts department, real, real, and they go by the seasons. So you go in April, when you're going to go back in August, it's going to be a different.
Entirely different.
About four times a year, they change the motif inside. The whole place, when you walk in, looks different. About four times a year. They do a great, great job. And thanks for all of you being our good sponsors, making this available to all of our friends out around the world with the internet service. We talk about it. We just soon talk about it around the world. And no cost to anybody to watch the Bobby Dupre Show. And so we thank all of them. And we have, we've taken care of all of our pictures, Dylan. We've taken care of our pictures. We have 5 minutes left. I noticed that we were asked to make an announcement, and I had also gotten it, a Bayou event that traces the history. On August the 15th, which is just a couple of weeks from now, a very special day is going to occur in Acadiana. That's going to be a Saturday, and that's for those that have the Roman Catholic Church as its faith. They're going to be celebrating the Feast of the Assumption of the Blessed Virgin Mary. And this is, they're going to be reenacting the people coming in. They're going to come in on boats, on little Tesh, just like they did back in, it doesn't
back
say
in the
here,
day, it doesn't say, how
it doesn't say, I don't, but it's commemorating 250th anniversary of the arrival of the Acadians by coming into St. Martinville on boats through Little Tesh. So quite an event. Bishop Jarrell has made it official, that it's an official celebration of the Catholic Church. And Bishop Provost has been asked to come and celebrate the first Mass at the Assumption of, at the St. Leo the Great Church in Leonville at 8 a.m. that Saturday morning. And he says it's a great privilege because all of my ancestors, I'm speaking for the Bishop Provost, all of my ancestors either came directly from France or were part of the Acadian exile in the 18th century.
Wow.
Beautiful, beautiful way to choose a person with the proper heritage. Thank you, Bishop Jarrell, for being kind enough to do all of that. And we need to keep these, because that's what tourism is built around, the heritage, the closeness we have, our ability to fight back when somebody comes from out of town and shoots, kills two of our young people, wounds nine others, gets the whole community in a rage, but then they come back together with love. With love. And it takes love to handle and settle all these different things. I noticed.
Before you get to that, too, I just want to say, too, you had mentioned about the jail and bail deal for charity for United Way. Well, one of our United Way people, Miss Susie, her daughter was actually in the theater when this happened, one row over from where the people got killed. So it really, just to show, it could have affected us in Opelousas also. I mean, you know, here's someone from Opelousas.
Right there. People we know.
Right.
Our cousins, as we like to call each other. A live professional boxing, Evangeline Downs, 7:30 p.m. Doors open at 6:30 p.m.
Bad Chad.
And Bad Chad is bringing another great set of boxing matches, usually has seven of them. It's very interesting. He does a great job of matching, and that's August the 8th, a couple of, not this Saturday, but next Saturday. And he's given me the heads up that we've got about a little less than 2 minutes. We go back on July the 29th of 2012. Miss Mary Catherine Reed passed away, and her son is John Duplishan, and John's wife, Lisa, is office manager for OPAC Financial Services. And Bill Walker, who was the husband of Tina Dukas Walker from Opelousas Palace Cafe, he died July the 29th, 14, just a year ago. And then Cass, Joseph Abram Castile, better known as Cass, he died July 29th, 2014. And Dr. Horman's father, Donald Horman, we call him Don Horman, died July 30th, 2014. And of course, that's Richard and Gary Horman. He coached them and he coached the boxing team. What a man. Our deepest sympathies to death of all those people. And my thought and my prayer for today, and I want to thank you again before I forget. Dear Heavenly Father, forgive me for focusing on my own schemes and dreams. Help me to look to you for guidance in all that I do. God wants to do what only He can do in and for us. Thank you for viewing. Tell a friend, and again, thank you for helping me on the program.
No problem.
Thank you, Dylan. Thank you, Andre.